ويلكم تو كايرو دار، اهلا بيكم ان شاء الله النهارده في حل الموديل انسر بتاع الفيزيكس اكزام. طبعا عشان كل واحد فينا يقيم نفسه كده ويشوف ايه اخطاه وايه وتعلم منها، وبرده ان شاء الله عشان احنا عندنا السبت الجاي الطلبه والطالبات بتوع الازهر الثانويه الازهريه عندهم امتحان يستفادوا من الامتحان النهارده ويشوفوا الموديل انسر بتاعته ايه. ورب يكون ان شاء الله كلنا يعني توفقنا في الامتحان وجبنا كويس. يعني نشوف الاكزام مع بعض. عندنا طبعا 5 كويستشنز. Answer 4 questions only from the following. هنختار طبعا 4 من 5 ونكمل. طبعا عندنا وقت احنا بنحل الايه قلنا 5 questions. Number 1 15 marks. Mention the scientific idea of each of the following. Number 1 the electric transformer. طبعا في electric transformer is based on the mutual induction between two coils. Okay, دي كده عندنا 1 mark. Number 2 cathode ray tube. Cathode ray tube depends on the thermoionic effect. Number 3 the magnetic levitated train. طبعا عارفين Meissner effect. Number 4 induction furnaces. Induction furnaces depends on the eddy current, production of eddy current or induced current in the soft iron core inside the coil. Number 5 direct current ammeter. Direct current ammeter طبعا هو الجالفانومتر، طبعا زي هو موديفايد جالفانومتر، يبقى احنا نقول ان الاميتر is based on the magnetic torque acting on the coil. وهنقول بقى كمان الاميتر ازود عليه ان هو هنخلي الاميتر of low resistance or low resistance عشان نخلي make the ammeter measure higher current intensity. يبقى هنقول اول حته the magnetic torque acting on the coil plus connecting small resistance to make the ammeter can measure a higher electric current intensity. Be first, what's meant by each of the following? Each of the following, number one, laser action. Laser action, طبعا عشان نشوف اللي هو الليزر ليزنج اكشن، طبعا نقول the active driving the atoms of the active medium into a state of population inversion عشان to be changed to population inversion هو الستيت طبعا in which the atoms number of atoms in the excited energy level more than the number of atoms in the lower energy level or the ground level عشان نعمل stimulated emission of radiation. يبقى to obtain stimulated emission of radiation. Number 2 Fraunhofer lines. Fraunhofer lines طبعا the dark lines appear in the spectrum of the sun represent absorption of spectrum vapor or gases of some element in the sun sphere or sun surface. Okay. Number 3 the electric conductivity of a material. Electric conductivity sigma equals طبعا L over RA. لما اقول sigma equals conductivity L divided RA. Therefore the conductivity of a conductor it is a reciprocal of the resistance of a conductor of length 1 meter and cross sectional area 1 meter square. Second طبعا عارفين ان كل سؤال 15 marks the first one 5 marks number في B first to B second 3 marks with 3 marks وال C طبعا عندنا هيبقى عندنا 4 marks عشان يبقى عندنا الكويشن كله 15 marks. Give reason for each of the following. Number 1 the two poles of the permanent magnet in the set of galvanometer are concave. طبعا هنا بنقول ان علشان to be make to make the galvanometer the magnet two poles of the magnet are concave طبعا to make the line magnetic flux lines as radial shape to make the plane of the coil parallel to the magnetic flux lines to make the torque maximum value. Okay. Number B, formation of different series of atomic spectral lines when exciting a group of hydrogen atoms. ليه بيحصل 5 series للسبكترم في الهيدروجين اتوم؟ طبعا عشان احنا ممكن نعمل excitation للهيدروجين اتومز for different energies عشان كده حصل له excitation for or two different energy levels. طبعا after relaxation different energies or different photons are emitted of different energies عشان كده بيطلع عندي 5 different series of different wavelengths. Number 3 quality of the electric potential difference across the two poles of electric cell and its electromotive force when no current flows through its current its circuit. طبعا لما اقول ان ال from Ohm's law for closed circuit V equals VB minus IR when the circuit is open, when the circuit is open the current intensity equals zero, therefore V equals VB. اوكي okay. يعني هنكتب الرول وهنقول الكلمتين دول عليه. عندي C problem. Sensitive galvanometer of coils resistance 50 ohm gives full scale deflection when a current is 0.002 ampere flows through it. It's connected to multiplier resistance of 450 ohm to convert it into a voltmeter. What is the maximum range of such voltmeter? يعني لغاية دلوقتي طبعا دي مسألة voltmeter. Okay. Givens بتاعتنا RG equals 50 ohm and IG equals 0.002 ampere. RM multiplier resistance equals 450 ohm. طبعا عايزين ال V maximum voltage rule RM equals طبعا دي direct problem V minus VG divided IG equals or ال RM 450 equals ال V unknown minus ال VG اللي هي IG RG اللي هي 50 times 0.002 divided the IG is 0.002. By cross multiplication, in the V equals 1 volt. Okay. Next. بقول لي باقي المسألة بيقول لي what's the maximum range of such voltmeter type if it is desired to use a voltmeter to measure the electric current intensity. يعني انا هعمل هنا بقى modification على الفولتميتر. فتكير انا عندي الفولتميتر after connecting RM or multiply resistance هعتبره galvanometer واعمله modification عشان احوله لايه؟ لاميتر. بيقول لي to measure the electric current use the voltmeter to measure the electric current intensity by connecting it with a shunt resistance RS 0.1. What is the maximum current intensity that can be measured by it? Okay. هنا اعتبر طبعا عندي ال RG اللي هي الجالفانومتر ريزيستنس بلس لان هو الفولتميتر نفسه ال RG equals ال RG الاوريجينال RG اللي هي الجالفانومتر كويل بلس ال RM اللي هي 450 بلس 50 equals 500 اوم. دي ال RG الجديدة بتاعت الايه الجهاز الجديد. طيب يبقى ال RS equals IG RG divided I minus IG RS مدهاني 0.1 given equals IG 0. The original current IG 0.002 times 500 divided I unknown minus 0.002 therefore I equals 10.002 ampere. That's the first question. Second question, write the scientific term of each of the following. Number one, the minimum energy required to free of electrons from the surface of a metal. طبعاً دي the work function EW. Two, a flow of electric charges in a conductor, the electric current, not the electric current intensity, electric current only. Number three, the effect that express the interactive or attractive forces between gas molecules. طبعا دي van der Waals effect. Number four, the energy level in an atom that is characterized by a relatively long lifetime, nearly 10 power negative 3 second, which is called metastable level. Number five, the scale deflection per unit current intensity flowing through the coil of galvanometer. Come on, this answer is the sensitivity of the galvanometer. Okay. B, first, mention one factor only from the factors that affect each of the following. طبعا ممكن قلنا لما يجي يقول لي mention one factors, one factor or two factors, three factors حسب ال givens اللي عندي من ال rule اللي انا هستخدمه. يعني number one, the magnetic force acting on a straight wire carrying an electric current placed perpendicular to a uniform magnetic field. طبعا نقول ان ال F equals BIL. يبقى الفاكتورز افكتنج ذا فورس نمبر 1 بي ودايركتلي اف دايركت مع بي. نمبر 2 ذا الكتريك كارنت انتنسيتي اف از دايركتلي بروبورشنال تو اي. نمبر 3 اف از دايركتلي بروبورشنال تو ال ذا لينث اوف ذا كوندكتور. اوكي نمبر 2 ذا ويف لينث اوف ذا لاين كاركترستيك سبيكتروم اوف اكس رايز. Characteristic line spectrum, طبعا عندنا هنا factor اللي هو the kind of the material of the target. Okay. Number three, the coefficient of self-induction, self-induction of a coil. طبعا self-induction اللي عندنا طبعا هو number of turns n, where the space between the turns will presence of the soft iron core أو magnetic permeability of the core. Second, compare between each of the following. Number one, Font series and Balmer series concerning the wavelength of the emitted radiation. احنا عارفين Fond series ال wavelengths بتاعتها في ال infrared او ال IR والبالمر في منطقة ال visible light او ال visible region. Number two, spontaneous emission and simulated emission of radiation concerning the wavelength of the emitted radiation. طبعا spontaneous emission دي has many wavelengths. Number two, the stimulated emission is monochromatic or has one wavelength. Number three, Ampere's right-hand rule and Fleming left-hand rule concerning the use of each. طبعا Ampere right-hand rule is used to determine the direction of the magnetic field around a straight wire. Okay, but Fleming left-hand rule is used to determine the direction of force or motion acting on a wire is carrying current is placed in a magnetic field, perpendicular in a magnetic field. See, the opposite figure shows a metal rod AB of length 0.25 meter moving with a linear velocity V 2 meter per second perpendicular to a magnetic field of flux density 0.4 tesla and its direction is perpendicular to the paper inwardly. طبعا الاكسس دي طبعا واضح انه direction of the magnetic field lines والdirection of V upward والwire نفسه AB او rod AB. عايز number one determine the direction of the current in the wire. Two, mention the name of the rule used to determine the direction of the current. Three, find the magnitude of the induced electromotive force in the wire. طبعا عشان نشوف الدايركشن بتاع الالكتريك واير وي ماست ابلاي فليمنج رايت هاند رول رايت لان ده هنا انديوسد كارنت ان ستريت واير. فليمنج رايت هنطبق فليمنج رايت على الدايجرام بتاعنا. تعال نشوف كده ادي الماجنتيك فيلد انتو ذا بيبر اور ذا بيج اور ذا بورد. هذا الرود AB. The direction of motion or velocity upward will direction of magnetic flux into the board. Therefore, by applying Fleming right hand rule, okay, the thumb finger represents the direction of motion or V will field pointed to the fourth finger into the board. Therefore, the electric current intensity passing through in the wire from B to A. Okay. Well, direction number one, direction of the electric current through the rod AB is from AB to A. Number two, mention the name of the rule used to determine the direction of the current. خلاص قلنا Fleming right hand rule. Number three, find the magnitude of the induced electromotive force in the wire. طبعا هنقول ان ال EMF in the wire equals negative BLV equals ال B 0.4 times L 0.25 times L velocity 2 meter per second equals 0.2 volt. Okay. Next question 3. Mention one use only for each of the following. Number 1, Dewar's flask. طبعا Dewar's flask is used to keep liquefied gases. Number two, the ohmmeter. The ohmmeter is used to measure the unknown resistance, the value of unknown resistance. Number three, Golgi tube. Golgi tube is used to produce X-rays, or Golgi tube is in production of X-rays. Number four, Lenz's rule. Lenz's rule طبعا is used to determine the direction of the induced EMF in a coil. يبقى الفرق بين Fleming right hand rule و Lenz's rule. Fleming right hand rule is used to determine the direction of induced current or induced EMF in a straight wire. Lenz's rule is used to determine the direction of magnetic electromotive force, induced electromotive force in a coil. The reference beam in holography. Reference beam in holography, طبعا دي reference beam which has the same wavelength or frequency of the original rays. We interfere with the original rays to form 3D image or in hologram. B first, prove mathematically that the wavelength accompanied to the motion of the photon is inversely proportional to its linear momentum. Okay. From the properties of photons or light, the wavelength lambda equals C divided the frequency nu. By multiplying this equation in times the H Planck's constant equals HC divided H nu, lambda equals CH divided H nu divided C. H equals H nu divided C, that the momentum of photon. Therefore, lambda equals H over PL. It means that lambda is inversely proportional to PL, is the momentum of the photon. Okay. Next. Second, by using the following physical units, form three groups of equivalent units, then state the physical quantity measured by each group. طبعا عندي هنا 6 units فيهم 3 groups, 3 equivalent groups, يعني عندي كل 2 في equivalent لبعض. Number 1 kilogram meter square per second و volt second per ampere, tesla meter per ampere, volt second per ampere meter و 5 عندي ohm meter و 6 joule second. طبعا عندي نمبر 1 ازاي بنعرف الحكايه دي. طبعا نقول لك نمبر 1 كيلوغرام متر سكوير بير سكند وانا عندي هنا نمبر 6 جول سكند. طب على الاقل ان انا اعمل يعني افك الجول كده. جول بتساوي ايه؟ جول سكند. جول ايكوالز كيلوغرام متر سكوير بير سكند سكوير تايم السكند. جول سكند جول بس كيلوغرام متر سكوير بير سكند سكوير و تايم السكند. سكند كانسل سكند يتفضل لي كيلوغرام متر سكوير بير سكند. يبقى ذا فيرست وان كيلوغرام متر سكوير بير سكند اند نمبر 6 جول سكند ار ايكويفالنت. وطبعا الفيزيكال كوانتي which is measured by جول سكند is the Planck's constant H. اوكي. Okay. Number two, عندي فولت سكند بير امبير، وطبعا نمبر 5 تحتها دي محفوظه، اوم سكند ار ايكويفالنت فولت سكند بير امبير ايكويفالنت لاوم سكند، طبعا لان فولت بير امبير ار ايكويفالنت ايكويفالنت تو اوم، يبقى فولت سكند بير امبير ايكويفالنت تو اوم سكند طبعا، وايكويفالنت تو لهنري هنري، والفيزيكال كوانتس طبعا ذا سيلف اندكشن او كوفيشنت اور ميتشوال اندكشن كوفيشنت. ذا لاست وان عندنا نمبر 3 تسلا متر دوت متر بير امبير، ونمبر 4 فولت سكند بير امبير دوت متر، وطبعا دي اتعلمناها من اللي لسه قبليها، يعني ما هو فولت سكند بير امبير ايكويفالنت تو فولت سكند تسلا متر بير امبير، طبعا هو دي اوريدي دي اللي فاضله، فولت سكند بير امبير تايمز متر، والتسلا متر بير امبير، ما انا ممكن التسلا بنفكها اللي هو ويبر بير متر سكوير، شوفها في صفحه ثانيه. عندي التسلا متر بير امبير، التسلا ويبر بير متر سكوير، اوكي تايمز متر ديفايدد امبير، متر كانسل متر اتفضل لي ويبر بير متر دوت امبير، اوكي وويبر بير امبير طبعا ويبر بير امبير متر دي اللي هو فولت سكند بير امبير، عشان كده هنقول ان ويبر بير امبير متر ايكويفالنت تو فولت سكند بير امبير متر، اللي هي نمبر 3 ونمبر 5. اوكي نيكست وان سي، عندي بروبلم على الكونكشن اوف ريزيستورز، ان الكتريك سيركت كونتينز 4 الكتريك ريزيستورز R1, R2, R3, and R4 ohm. If the electric current intensity that flows through each of them is 0.3 again, 0.4, 0.2 ampere respectively, and the value of R1 equals 6 ohm, R3 equals 15 ohm, and the internal resistance of the battery 1 ohm. Number one, show by drawing the method of connection of these resistors. Number two, calculate the total resistance of the circuit. Number three, calculate the electromotive force of the electric source. Okay. طبعا لما نيجي نشوف ال values of the electric current intensity يعني 0.3 و 0.3 في اللي هي R1 و R2 دي حاجة من الاثنين، يعني الاثنين دول are connected in series، يا اما الاثنين are connected in parallel and are equal، يعني هما واضح هما equal. طيب لما نشوف R3 و R4 هنلاقي ان R4 carrying current 0.2 و R3 carrying current 0.4، يبقى برضو واضح ان هم هيبقى connected in parallel، والتوتال current فيهم 0.6، و R1 و R2 برضو التوتال current فيهم 0.6 اللي هو 0.3 plus 0.3. اوكي لان بحسب الفولتج، طبعا انا بحسب الفولتج، يعني عندي هنا R R1 R1 equals R1 carrying current 0.3 و equals 6 ohm بس ال again okay the last one R1 equals 6 ohm and then R2 R3 R4 طبعا هتقول لي عرفت ان طريقه الكونكشن بالطريقه دي، انا بحسب حسبت الفولتج اللي على ار 1 اللي هو طبعا كارنت هنا 0.3 امبير. اوكي طيب فالفولتج بيطلع 0.3 تايم 6 هيبقى 1.8، الفولتج هنا ايكوالز 1.8 فولت على ار 1. طيب لما اجي احسب الفولتج اللي على ار 3 جيفن بتاعتي الار 3 ب 15 اوم والكارنت فيها 0.4 هيدينا 0.4 تايم 15 هيبقى هنا 4 15 والكارنت فيها 0.4 امبير. يبقى الفولتج هنا equals 0.4 times 15 equals 6 فولت. طبعا طالما ال R1 has different voltage from R3 يبقى اكيد R1 و R3 are connected in series طالما الفولتج different. طيب هو بيقول لي كمان ان ال R1 carrying current equal the value of R2، يبقى هجرب ان R1 connected parallel to R2 ولو الكرنت ذا سيم 0.3 يبقى R2 must equal 6 ohm. اوكي اند R4 طبعا ممكن اجيبها من الفولتج، ما R1 R3 و R4 are connected in parallel، the voltage across R3 equal 6 volt يبقى الفولتج across R4 equals also 6 volt. طيب والكرنت passing through R4 0.2 ampere therefore the value of R4 equals 6 divided 0.2 equals 30 ohm. okay طبعا ممكن هنا نحسب التوتال كرنت، التوتال كرنت equals 0.3 plus 0.3 but total current equals 0.6 امبير. اوكي ومنها التوتال ريزيستنس، طبعا هقول ان R1 و R2 are connected in parallel و 6 times 6 divided 6 plus 6 or 6 over 2 equals 3 ohm يبقى R dash equals 3 ohm. اوكي و R3 and R4 are connected in parallel also 15 times 30 divided 15 plus 30 يبقى R double dash equals 10 ohm. okay يبقى ال total R ال equivalent R equals 3 plus 10 equals 13 ohm وال R بيقول بقى calculate ال total R او total resistance of the circuit اللي R total equals R dash plus R double dash plus R small equals 3 plus 10 plus 1 equals 14 ohm. اوكي كمان عايز نمبر 3 the calculate the electromotive force of the electric source طبعا هنا from Ohm's law VB equals I times total R plus small r I 0.6 times the R 13 plus 1 equals 0.6 times 14 equals 8.4 volt. okay question 4 A when does each of the following values equal 0. Number one, the resistance of a platinum wire connected in an electric circuit when an electric current flows through it. امتى الريزيستنس بتاعت البلاتينم كوندكتور ايكوال زيرو؟ طبعا at very low temperature او at temperature near to 0 degree Kelvin which loses its electrical resistance completely and it changes it to superconductor material. Number two, the torque acting on a coil through which an electric current flows and plays in a uniform magnetic field. امتى التورك equals zero؟ ما احنا عارفين التورك equals بيان sin theta. Torque equals بيان ساين ثيتا امتى الترك بزيرو وانا عندي بي واي واي وان ار كونستنت؟ يبقى طبعا لما تكون ساين ثيتا ايكوال زيرو اور وين ذا بلين اوف كويل بيربنديكولار to the magnetic flux line. طبعا فين التورك؟ الثيتا بتبقى بزيرو امتى؟ لما يكون الكويل perpendicular to the magnetic flux line. يبقى اقول when the plane of coil is perpendicular to the magnetic flux lines and therefore theta equals zero and sine theta equals zero, therefore torque equals bn sine theta equal zero. Number three, the total magnetic flux density at a point outside two straight parallel wires carry electric current. امتى ال2 لما يكون عندي 2 parallel wires carrying current عايز ال عندنا بي توتال اللي هنسميها نيوترال بوينت عندي بوينت outside the two wires امتى يكون في عندي بي توتال هنا equal 0 طبعا لما يكون في هنا بي 1 minus بي 2 امتى بي 1 minus بي 2 بتساوي 0 لما يكون ال 2 fields are in opposite directions الكلام ده امتى لما يكون ال 2 currents in the two parallel wires are in the same direction علشان بيبقى between the two between the two current two wires ال B total equal zero هنا لما يكون B1 minus B2 عشان كده عندي لما يكون the two currents in the two wires are in opposite directions. Okay. Next one, the average electromotive force induced in a coil rotating in a uniform magnetic field. امتى الافرج الكتروموتيف فورس بتساوي 0 في كويل؟ هنا بقى الكويل يعني طبعا نقول ان البي ايكوالز بانو ساين ثيتا اي ام اف ايكوالز ساين ثيتا. هنا برضه نقول امتى الساين ثيتا بزيرو؟ لما تكون ثيتا بزيرو يعني لما تكون برضه البلين اوف كويل بيربنديكولار تو ذا ماجنتيك فلكس line. طبعا عندي هنا average electromotive force induced EMF وممكن طبعا نقول الافرج طالما بيسالنا على الافرج induced EMF when the coil rotates complete cycle when the coil complete cycle من الرول بيقول EMF equals Faraday's law negative n delta phi divided delta t عارفين الافرج EMF بتساوي 0 لما يعمل complete cycle عشان الدلتا phi equals 0 يعني خلينا في السكند انسر افضل بي فيرست تشوز ذا كوريكت انسر. هنا عندي برضو بروبلم على تشابتر 9 كونكشن اوف ريزيستورز. نمبر 1 ان ذا اوبوزيت سيركت ذا فاليو اوف ار ايكوالز 20 40 60 ومديني الجيفنز الفي بي ايكوالز 120 فولت والار 8 اوم وعندي النون ار وفي ار معاها بارلل 5 اوم والكرنت ان باسنج ثرو ذا سيركت 10 امبير والريزيستنس توتال انترنال ريزيستنس ايكوالز 0. طبعا عندي التوتال فولتج والتوتال كارنت نقدر نجيب التوتال ريزيستنس ار توتال فروم اومز لو ايكوالز في بي ديفايدد اي الفي بي ايكوالز 120 ديفايدد اي اللي هو 10 ايكوالز 12 او اوكي therefore عندي total resistance 12 عندي resistance 8 ohm are connected 8 ohm are is connected in series to the unknown resistance and the 5 ohm يبقى هقول ان ال value بتاعت ال R اللي هي ال unknown هجيبها من هقول ان هي R dash or for example equals 12 minus 8 equals 4 ohm okay ده الايكويفالنت ريزيستنس اوف ذا تو ريزيستورز بارلل اللي هم ار وال5 اوم يعني هقول بقى 4 اوم ايكوالز 4 تايمز ار ديفايدد 4 بلس ار كروس مالتيبليكيشن طبعا تطلع الار ايكوالز 20 اوم يعني الانسر اوف ذا فيرست كويشن از 20. نمبر 2 ليزر ريز ار كاركترايزد باي keeping their intensity for long distances. This means that they have one wavelength, are coherent, doesn't obey inverse square law, طبعا لما اقول هي keeping its intensity for long distances يبقى obey, it doesn't obey inverse square law. Number three, in the opposite figure, when the magnet moves in the direction shown, the intensity of illumination of the lamp increases, decreases, vanishes. طبعا لما بص على الرسم هنا هنلاقي ان يعني بعمل removing للماجنت from the coil. طبعا عشان نشوف ال polarity of the magnet هنشوف الايه هنلاقي ان البول S is removed or away from the coil. يعني لما يكون عندي شوفها برضو مع بعض كده, عندي كويل لامب وباتري has a direction key, direction of the battery طبعا in this direction, current in this direction, okay, واللامب is illuminated. طبعا عندي ماجنت بقى S و N. The magnet is removed away from the coil. Therefore, the near face, according to Lenz's rule, this face is also north, طبعا to attract or to resist the change causing it, اللي هو يبقى عندي هنا north pole. Okay? Therefore, if this face or pole is north pole, the current in this turn is in the direction of A. anti-clockwise direction. Okay, anti-clockwise direction يعني هيبقى في الدايركشن ده كده, والدايركشن ده لما يكون anti-clockwise direction يبقى in the same direction of the battery, in the same direction of the battery, therefore the illumination of the lamp increases. Okay, number four, a monochromatic light falls on a metal surface, electrons are freed. If another monochromatic light of higher energy and the same intensity falls on the same metal, the number of emitted electrons increases, decreases, is not changed. طبعا لما يكون ال energy of the incident photon increases, يبقى ال kinetic energy of the emitted electrons increases. But when the intensity is constant, the number of electrons is constant. يبقى هنا الانسر تبقى is not changed. Second, the opposite graph represent a relation between resistance of a conductor and its length. يبقى عندي R and the length of the two wires A and B of different materials having the same cross-sectional area, يعني ال area constant. Okay, number one, which one of the two wires has greater specific resistance, طبعا specific resistance or resistivity. L R وعندي two wires A and B. Okay. طبعا calculate the slope of each. Which one of the two wires has a greater slope? طبعا A, the slope of A greater than slope of B. طيب what is the slope of each? Slope equals R divided L, و R divided L equals rho E اللي هي resistivity or specific resistance divided A, لأن ال R resistance equals rho E L divided A. ال area constant, okay, يبقى the wire which has greater slope has the greater greater resistivity or specific resistance. طالما ان ال slope of A greater than slope of B, يبقى the wire A has greater than the resistivity from B. طبعا بيقول لي and why, اقول له the resistivity of wire A more than or greater than resistivity of wire B because the slope of A more than slope of B. Okay, كمان بيقول لي which one, number two, in the two wires that are connected If the two wires are connected together in parallel in an electric circuit, which one of them carries greater electric current and why؟ طبعا اللي ليها طبعا higher او greater resistivity اللي هو الA يبقى اكيد ليه ريزيستنس كبيره لما يمشي فيه current لما يكون divided to عندي parallel connection والcurrent يحصل له division. لو قلت R1 اللي هو الA وR2 اللي هو B, R has higher resistance يبقى الكرنت اللي هيمشي في الA I1 less than I2. اوكي يبقى هو عايز الماكسيمم كرنت او which one of the of them carries greater electric current, يبقى الواير B is the wire which carries the greater current because طبعا its resistivity less than the wire A. Number C problem, an AC dynamo, its coil consists of 420 turn, the cross sectional area of each 3 times 10 power 3 negative 3 meter square, rotates in a magnetic field of flux density 0.5 tesla. If the coil starts rotating from the position perpendicular to the flux lines and reaches to maximum induced electromotive force after 1 over 200 second, given that by equal to 22 over 7, calculate number 1, the maximum induced electromotive force to the time needed for the current to reach half its maximum value. شوف مع بعض. الاريه كروس سكشن اريا A equals 3 times 10 power negative 3 meter squared. Well, N number of turns is 420 turns. Well, B magnetic flux density equals 0.5 tesla. Well, in the time equals 1 divided 200 second. Time the A of A, time the law of reaching or after rotation quarter cycle, and purely from the position perpendicular to the magnetic flux lines and reach it to the maximum induced electromotive force, يعني after quarter cycle. Okay, طيب يبقى هقول ان الEMF max EMF max equals negative B A N omega layer 2 by F times sine theta. Okay, therefore طبعا theta الأول هنقول theta equals 2 by F T. Okay, طبعا quarter cycle يبقى theta equals 90 equals 2 times ال باي هنا تكير 180 times ال F times ال T اللي هي 1 over 200. From this equation ال F equals 50 هرتز. اوكي طيب بعد كده عايز هو ال EMF maximum. هقعد بقى في الفيرست رول اللي هو ادي ال B وال A وال N 2 باي F جبنا F وساين ثيتا طبعا ثيتا ب 90 يبقى EMF equals negative 420 times 3 times 10 power negative 3 times 0.5 times 2 times by 22 over 7 times 50 اللي هي الF times 50 okay equals 192 volt. Okay, sorry, equals 198 اوكي. نمبر 2 عايز the time needed, time needed for the current to reach half its maximum value. طبعا هقول بقى ان ال EMF من الرول EMF instantaneous value equals the EMF maximum times sin theta. هو عايز ال half its maximum, بقول هنا half EMF max equals EMF max times sin theta. يبقى sin theta equals half therefore theta equals 30. okay. طيب يبقى ال time طبعا نفس الرول theta equals 2 by f t 30 equals 2 times أيوة 180 not 22 over 7 times ال f 50 times t therefore t equals 1 over 600 second. okay. Next, question 5, the last one. What are the results of each of the following? طبعا relaxation of an excited from excited atom from an excited state to lower state after lifetime interval is over. طبعا هنا what are the results? هنقول photons, incoherent photons are emitted due to the spontaneous emission or ordinary light طبعا يعني not laser. Number 2, flowing of electric current in two opposite directions through two straight parallel wires close to each other. لو عندي two wires زي الاكزامبل التاني, عندي two wires carrying current, ال current two in two opposite directions طبعا يبقى ال B total between them plus or summation يعني هيبقى more than the B total outside the two wires, therefore the two wires repel each other away from each other. Number 3, flowing a direct current, direct electric current through a solenoid طبعا it will magnetized and it change it to electromagnet. Number 4, drawing heat from a gas, drawing or withdrawal يعني take heat from a gas by contacting a pre-cooled substance to a temperature near 20 Kelvin. طبعا the gas loses its viscosity and changes to superfluid. Number 5, the absence of two parallel mirrors at the two ends of laser tube. طبعا there is no magnification or amplification of intensity and it doesn't produce laser. B first, mention three only from the properties of X-rays. Three only, نقول الفور properties. Number one, they can penetrate media easily. Number two, can ionize gases. طبعا number three, diffracting crystals where they affect sensitive photographic plate. ده كده four properties. Second, عندنا figure one and figure two. Figure one shows the resultant current through the external circuit of an electric generator. Figure 2 طبعا واضح ان ال first generator is the AC generator, AC اللي هو alternating current. Figure 2 shows the resultant current through external circuit of the same electric generator after making a certain modification. يعني نفس الجنريتور بس عملت فيه modification طلع لي الكرنت التاني اللي هو هيبقى اسمه ايه unidirectional current. اوكي نمبر 1 بقى بيقول لي what is the difference between the two currents. طبعا the first one is alternating current, the second one is unidirectional current. نمبر 2, what is the modification made on the electric generator. طبعا عملت replacement للtwo slip rings of the AC generator by commutator, اللي هي two halves of commutator. Number 3, why can't a meter be used to measure the resultant current in both figures. طبعا لان الاميتر or galvanometer can measure DC only, measure a DC which is constant intensity, has constant intensity. But the first one, اللي هو alternating current, has variable magnitude and variable direction. يعني pointer of the galvanometer, if this frequency is low frequency, the pointer of the galvanometer vibrate around zero scale. يعني it doesn't stop at a certain value. يعني it can't measure the AC. Number two, unidirectional current, it has constant direction but has variable magnitude. يعني it doesn't stop at a certain value only, لأنه هيحصل له variation. يعني the pointer of the galvanometer increases and decreases to zero scale again, increases and decreases to zero scale again if the frequency is low frequency. If both frequencies are high frequencies, the pointer of the galvanometer doesn't deflect. Okay. Finally, see an electric transformer on the graph. Electric transformer of a changeable number of secondary coil turns NS is used to obtain different values of output potential difference VS. The following table shows the relation between VS, low voltage out from the secondary coil, and NS, the number of turns of the secondary coil. Draw the graphical relation between VS on y-axis will NS on the x-axis. طبعا الجراف ده من الحاجات السهلة. عندي هنا NS و VS. اوكي. يعني according to values اللي مدهاني. طبعا الفالز هنا irregular, لكن ممكن نحط احنا هنا irregular numbers 50 100 150 200. اوكي. والفي اس 96 96 يبقى 140 30 نيرلي نحسبها, و 150 هتبقى 120 هنا, و 200 تبقى 192. اوكي. طبعا لما نرسم الستريت لاين بتاعنا نحط نمبر 1 50 و 48 160 و 150 و 140 120 200 و 200 120 200 وطبعا 200 مش عندنا يبقى 150 144. اوكي. 144 لو وصلت البوينت دي بيطلع ستريت لاين. طبعا يقول لي نمبر 1 from the graph find the slope of straight line. السلوب طبعا equals it. Choose two points, say the first one 50 و 48 و 100 و 96, يبقى تساوي 96 - 48 divided 100 - 50. اوكي. هيطلع طبعا 0.90 0.96. اوكي. ده السلوب اوف ذيس جراف. نمبر 2 بيقول لي ذا ريزلتنت باور from the secondary coil when its number of turns becomes 200 and the resistance of its circuit 75. طبعا عايز الباور, بس الاول هجيب ال V at 200. هشوف كده at 200 طبعا equals 192, يبقى هاخد الفولتج 192 واقول ان الباور equals V squared divided R. ال V square اللي هي 192 power 2 divided R اللي هي 75 equals 491 5 وات. اوكي وبكده يبقى خلصنا اجابه الامتحان، ويا رب تكونوا كلكم عملتوا اجابات صحيحه، وان شاء الله رب يكون لكم تحصلوا على الدرجات النهائيه وتكملوا بقيه الامتحانات على خير ان شاء الله، وكل سنه وانتم طيبين، والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله.